The term foundry just refers to the process of melting metal of any kind. In our case, we're mainly casting bronze. We do cast aluminum occasionally and brass and iron and copper, but our primary focus is bronze for sculptures, so we would be considered an art foundry. Just the process of melting the metal and casting it into some kind of mold to capture whatever detail was in the original sculpture.
So first step is an artist will bring a sculpture into Bronze Age art casting. Usually it's in clay, but it could be another material. From there, to replicate it in bronze, we'll take it through what's called the lost wax casting process. But the first step is to make a rubber mold, a silicone rubber mold of the sculpture. So what we're going to do is basically divide up the sculpture in a way that's useful by creating a shim. We're going to paint rubber on both sides of the sculpture. We'll do about three coats, a print coat and a few other coats to build up a layer of flexible rubber mold. And the rubber won't be able to stick to itself because there's a shim between the two halves.
Once the plaster is cured, we just call it demolding. We'll take the plaster mold off, peel off the rubber mold. And if it's a two-part mold, like say in the case of a head or an arm or a torso, once we've taken it off the original sculpture, we put that back together and then it goes into the wax room where we'll pour wax into it, a series of what's called slushing. We'll pour in and then out until we build up the thickness we want. Once the wax is cooled, we'll again demold it, pull the wax out of the mold. And we have to have a way to feed metal into that piece. So then we're adding a sprue system. We'll add gates, a runner, and a pour cup. And that'll all feed the metal into the piece once it's invested. So from there, it goes to their shell room. We're investing it, we call it, because we're investing that one wax. So that original rubber and plaster mold, we can reuse. We could pull hundreds of wax patterns out of that mold. But the investment mold that we're investing the wax into is only a one-time use. So in our case, we're doing a ceramic shell. It's a slurry. We'll dip it in, coat it with a sand, and let it dry and then repeat.
When it's complete and dry, it'll get put into a kiln. And then the kiln is utilized to melt the wax out of that system. And that wax can be reclaimed and reused. And then what's left is a hollow wax shell. We call this a ceramic shell or shell mold. And that's the space into which we pour the molten bronze.
We'll burn the wax out. That firing in the kiln also vitrifies that ceramic shell, makes it a little harder for the pressure of the bronze hits it. At that point, it's ready for to pour bronze into. So we'll melt the bronze, we'll set up the shells in a pit of sand to support them. And when the bronze is to the, usually around 2000 to 2100 degrees, depending on how thin and small they are, bigger, thicker things will pour a little cooler. But then we'll simply just pour the bronze into those ceramic shells.
When the metal is cooled, we can break off that ceramic shell. There's really no way to get the metal out without doing that. And then what's inside should be exactly what we started out with in wax.
Then there's usually some finish work involved in the bronze, some grinding and welding perhaps. When we weld those together, we call it chasing. We have to put that original texture back into the sculpture so it looks like the original clay and you can't tell that it was welded together. Once that's done, we'll give it a light sandblast to get some clean metal and even, you know, so there's not the different textures from sanding and grinding. And then we apply a patina, and usually we're using a liver of sulfur that will darken it, and then we can rub it back with Scotch-Brite pads to highlight areas and get a little bit of the metal coming through, and then we'll spray a ferric nitrate over that to get different kind of warm tones, anywhere from amber, gold, all the way up to, you know, red and brown, or even very dark, you know, brownish black colors. And then after that, we'll seal up the bronze to help protect it. And basically that's it in a nutshell. It's not easy work. I really enjoy the whole process of casting bronze and help, you know, making other artists' work come to light, make their dreams come true, I guess. As an artist myself, I like the whole process, and then having other, you know, other artists working here that they understand the process, they have an appreciation of art, and also maybe, you know, an eye to see detail, just trying to make it look as much like the original clay sculpture as we can, and we kind of take pride in that.